Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. I was at the butcher shop over the weekend looking at getting some meat to put into our dryager cabinets, and I saw these beef ribs, and I thought, let's make some beef ribs. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut a lot of the fat off of the top side. As you can see, there's quite a layer of fat here, so I'm just going to get with a knife, and I'm going to cut that right down to the meat. So I think I've got most of the really hard fat from the cap taken off, as well as the silver skin. And this hard fat that I've taken off isn't going to render out. What's going to render out is the fat that's inside the muscle. And that's going to give us a really unctuous mouthfeel and flavor. And I'm going to cook these really low and slow so that all of that connective tissue breaks down into something that is super, super flavorful. Today I'm also going to make northern style cornbread and tart tatin. Now, as a binder, I'm going to use our homemade Worcester sauce. And as you can see, it is super thick. I haven't thinned it out. I think the flavor is fantastic this way. I may thin it out later. I'm really impressed with how well this came out. So I'm just going to rub that all over the ribs. And if you've noticed, I left the membrane on the back because of our long, slow cook. If you take the membrane off of these beef ribs, they'll just fall apart on the grill. And yeah, I don't want that to happen. I want them to come off the grill and look really good. So now that I've got the binder rubbed in, it smells amazing. Smells amazing. I'm just going to do a salt and pepper rub. I'm going to keep it really simple today. Just very basic flavors. Let the beef shine through. So I'm going to use a 50-50 salt and pepper mix, and I've got that right here. And you want to cover everything. Really generous cover. All sides, the end, top, bottom, everything. Maybe do the backside, even though it's not going to add much flavor. It might add a bit of flavor at the end. Okay, so I'm just going to clean up and then we'll head out to the smoker. So I've got the pellet grill preheated to 230 degrees Fahrenheit and I'm running maple today because I really like maple. And I'm going to put these on the lower rack and I'm going to let them go for about an hour, hour and a half before I come back out to check them. Don't lift the lid. Okay, we are 5 hours into the cook and looking fantastic. Got some great bark on top. And I'm looking for a temperature that's between 195 and 205 internal. And depending on where we are in this thickness, we're almost there. I'm gonna say another 20 minutes is gonna get us there. I'm gonna call it. I'm gonna say that these ribs are done. We are at about 5.5 hours in the smoker. Now, I didn't wrap them at all while I was smoking them. A friend of mine, Ted Reeder, and if you're Canadian, you might know who Ted is. He's had, I don't know, 20 cookbooks or so. He is a product developer, recipe developer. If you live in Canada, you've probably tasted something that Teddy has come up with. His suggestion to me was, don't wrap them while you're cooking them. Once you reach that 195 to 205 temperature range, then wrap them. Stick them into a warming oven or a holding oven at 175 degrees Fahrenheit and leave them there for at least an hour. But 12 to 24 hours is even better, apparently. That just gives everything a chance to relax and come together. But these are looking amazing. So I'm gonna wrap them up and get them into the warming oven. Good. Looking good. Ooh.
Glen, that looks good. You said bring wine. I see why now.
Okay, so.
Hey, friends.
Beef ribs. Okay, these are looking pretty good. The,
Oh.
Look at that.
What, my bad spilling?
No, the ribs.
The ribs look good.
So I'm given to understand that if you're a real barbecue channel, this is where you squeeze the rib to show how juicy it is. Look at that. But we're not a real barbecue channel. But I did it anyway.
I'm gonna get a fork. You cut me off a piece.
Well, let's cut that one off the bone and then slice off some of this meat. Look at
that. Pretty good.
So that is slow smoked. Took about 5.5 hours, maybe almost six.
That's a big piece.
Only salt and pepper with our homemade Worcester sauce.
Oh, fabulous.
Put on first to hold the, to stick everything together. So the flavor from the bark is amazing. Super juicy meat. Just a little bit of that hint of smoke flavor. I used maple, so it's quite light. So these were from the chuck end. They had a lot of really good marbling and a lot of connective tissue, and it broke down completely. I'm really happy with these. And it's the best part. To me, it's the best part of the roast. Anytime we do a standing rib roast,
I love the ribs,
all right, the actual bones.
I see that there's more to this meal, so for now, I shall toast you.
Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you in a moment for some cornbread.